Anyway, so who do you see, though, in the current crop of GOP candidates who gets that? Who gets that it's not just about politics in Washington, D.C.? It's not just about policy papers, but it's about reaching the culture. Is there anyone?
Well, Sarah Palin, obviously. I mean, Sarah Palin, if they, that's why they want to destroy her, because they recognize that she had a transcendent pop cultural factor. It doesn't mean that they can't destroy her. That's their goal. They're trying to attack her. She should be on the cover of my book.
Good evening. My name is Isabel, and this is Headline News Update. Now, some chicken soup for the soul of America. Governor Palin spoke and answered questions at Southeastern University's annual leadership forum on Friday. According to Twitter, she told students to do what others won't. She is said to have encouraged her audience to cling to your gods, your guns, your constitution. Don't allow faith to be pushed to the margins of our culture. Former Alaskan Governor Sarah Palin was fired up about God and country when she spoke Friday at Southeastern University in Lakeland, and she was dressed for the part. The 2008 Republican vice presidential candidate visited the Sunshine State at the request of the organizers of the school's 7th annual Leadership Forum. She was quite a presence on the stage in a lipstick red suit and fierce high heels. Her passionate talk was peppered with such vibrant cries as cling to your God, your guns, your constitution, and please for the next generation to change the country's moral fiber. That will make our foundation crumble if we choose to ignore it, she said. Not one to tiptoe around sensitive topics, Palin got right to the point on reasons she said the country is in crisis. Today, look around, and don't you wonder sometimes if, as a nation, we have forgotten God altogether? This is a crucial question, she said. Palin said the school asked her to talk about hope and resilience. She said she would, but not that Washington, D.C., hopey, changey, blah, blah stuff, but real hope. Mostly, the 49-year-old hammered such topics as the corruption of Washington, D.C., it's a hotbed of cronyism, and federal spending. The federal government is bloated, corrupt, and out of control. Palin said she was happy to visit a Christian school, and she encouraged students to go forth and spread the word. She encouraged them to, quote-unquote, infiltrate the nation, study journalism, and get into Hollywood and the sports world. Get out there and influence culture, she said. Palin closed her talk with a battle cry. The future of the country depends on what you do, she said. God bless you. Sarah Palin on John Brennan. Something else that didn't get a lot of news this week were the 16 who voted down Obamacare. Justin Amash, Michigan. Tim Hulskamp, Kansas. Jim Bridenstine, Oklahoma. Paul Bruhn, Georgia. Louis Gohmert, Texas. Walter Jones, North Carolina. Dana Rohrabacher, California. John Fleming, Louisiana. Phil Gingrey, Georgia. Jack Kingston, Georgia. Tom McClintock, California. Thomas Massey, Kentucky. Steve Pierce, New Mexico. Matt Salmon, Arizona. Ted Yoho from Florida. And Mo Brooks from Alabama. Thank you for voting against the funding of Obamacare. Go Ted Cruz.